Yo, what's up guys, welcome back to another YouTube video. In this video I'm going to be testing out the challenger badge. I'm going to be looking at all the variants from none all the way up to Hall of Fame against Steph Curry, just because he has a high three ball and we can see the effectiveness of the badge at each tier. So I did just what I usually do in my videos. I made five different builds. 6'8", he's 180 pounds, 6'7" wingspan. All of the attributes are constant throughout all five builds. The only attribute that is different is perimeter defense. Your perimeter defense is what determines what level of challenger you have. So in this case, our challenger with no badge has 70 perimeter defense. For bronze, he is going to have 71 perimeter defense, 82 perimeter defense for silver, 87 for gold, and 94 for Hall of Fame. And yeah, without further ado, let's get into it. All right, guys, this is Future Me. I just want to let you guys know that it is really hard to test the accuracy of the badge throughout the different tiers. I did the best I could by trying to keep the defense consistent, but you'll notice my player is more sticky and I'm getting higher contests by just being in the area, the higher the badge tier goes. What I'm trying to say is make sure you guys watch the progression from none to bronze to silver to gold to Hall of Fame. Also, this is me again. I'm watching this back. I don't know why my voice sounds like this. It sounds like I have a filter on my voice. I don't know what that is. So what I'll be doing is I'll just give Curry the ball. I'll let him shoot and I'll see what the contest percentage is. I'll give him an equal amount of space for all the badges. Of course, there's going to be some variability, but we'll get a general gist of what each badge is like. The difficulty is on Superstar, which is park difficulty. I'm just going to put my hand up, give a little bit of space so we can shoot. Yeah, there we go. 8% contest. Okay. Open coverage. Open coverage again. And that was open again. Okay, so we only got one contest. Okay, so for no challenger and 70 premier defense, I only got like one 8% contest. We'll see if I get more contests with bronze. All right, so this is 71 premier defense and bronze challenger. Open coverage. Wide open coverage there. ...56% contest there. Open coverage. Wide open coverage there. Okay, so for bronze challenger, I did get 156% contest. Everything else was pretty much open or wide open. So not really a big difference between 70 and 71 perimeter defense. Alright, so we're testing silver challenger now. That was an open coverage, not wide open. That was a 51% contest. That was a 33% contest. I'm noticing I'm getting a little more stick with my contests than I was with bronze or silver. I mean, bronze or none. That was an open coverage. That was an open coverage. All right, so for silver challenger, I noticed that the shots that were wide open for bronze or none were just open, and the shots that were open for bronze were actually contested. One of the contests was red, and one of them was like around 20%, I think. I also did notice it's easier to stick when he's doing that step back. It was easier to stick. All right, so now we're testing gold challenger. Oh, wow, so just the first one, I noticed how easy it was for my guy to stay with him during his step back. I don't know if you guys saw that or not. Yeah, 53% contest there. Contest there. It's just like usually my player would kind of just let him shoot, but now I'm like, that was an open. Now I'm kind of, it's easier to stick, if that makes sense. That was an open. Usually those are wide open. With silver, we saw those being wide open. That one was also open. I feel like that's something that would have been wide open with the other. Alright, so for gold challenger, I definitely noticed a difference between silver, bronze, and none. I didn't really notice a difference. It's not, you know, it's not going to make that big of a difference. But for gold, it was easier to stick. As you guys saw that last shot, that should have been wide open. It was not wide open. It was just open. You know, open mean open is basically lightly contested because it's not wide open. It's open. So yeah, gold challenger, you can definitely see a difference. Let's try Hall of Fame. All right, so this is Hall of Fame challenger. Yeah, I was nowhere near him and it was an open. Again, that was an open. I was nowhere near him. That was an open. Again, I was nowhere near him. That was 9% contest. There. All right, I just finished Hall of Fame Challenger and I did not notice that much of a difference from gold. I did notice a big jump from silver to gold, but not from gold to Hall of Fame. So yeah, there are a lot of variables in this. You can't really test it, I guess, but from just by feeling it out, kind of judging the defense. All right, and so there was no real like statistical way to test this. The best I could do was just like kind of feel it out. I did try playing the same defense. So like I just gave him a little bit of space to shoot and gave myself enough time to recover to see what badge recovers fastest to give me the highest contest, if that makes sense. The only thing I really noticed was it was easier to stick as the badge goes up. But if I was just in the area, the contest would be a little bit higher. Especially from silver to gold, not really from gold to Hall of Fame, I didn't notice. So right. I'm just going with the gut. Never had a doubt, felt like this is just a must. Put me in perspective, I'm the deepest in the cut. Everybody tune in.